Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Okay, so now it's homework time. Well, not homework, it is class exercise time, and I'd love for you to go through and do this. Now, when I'm running my in-classroom training, okay, I find this is the most valuable part of the whole experience. Instead of following me step by step, you'll run into problems and be able to fix them yourself. Now, like I do in my classroom training, I've got a checklist. I'd like you to do all of these things, please. So set aside some little bit of time now, okay, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, it might take you an hour, depending on how fast you're picking it up. But nicely, you get to do this at home at your own pace. So go through and do every single thing on this list, and when you're finished, you can use this thing in your portfolio. You have permission, okay, you can use this in your portfolio to say, this is something that I've made, and it is. What I'd also like you to do is send me a copy, okay? You might follow this verbatim, and that's totally fine. I just want to see that you've done it. Send it to me, okay? Depending on where you're watching this videos, often there's a comments or a class exercise part, so stick it in there. Either the PDF or the JPEG version, or even a screenshot, okay? And just work you through those lists. So let me quickly help you with what you need to do. So new document, easy, but in that new document, it needs to be a US half letter or A5, depending on which part of the world you're in. Needs to be a bleed of 3 millimeters or 1/8 of an inch, depending on what part of the world you're from. Okay, facing pages are going to be turned off. We're going to make it landscape. I want you to create your very own new library for this client here called Green Gardener. Call it that. Add the brand colors. You'll see that in your exercise files. There they are there. Okay, there is something called, so an O1 flyer, there's one called class exercise. And in here are your colors. There's the colors there. Okay, there's the checklist that I'm reading through now as well. You can read through it on your own time if you don't want to pause this video. And here's some other bits. This is the finished file that you can kind of see in the background here. So you can use that as an example if you get lost. Okay, and other things you need to do, add those brand colors. Okay, and add them to your CC library. You need to use a logo that's in there and one of the images. There's three to pick from. You can use your own. That's totally fine. You can use your own logo, your own colors. I'd love you to do that. Okay, but if you just want to kind of charge on and finish them, okay, you can just use the example stuff. Your image needs to be cropped like this one. Okay, it's a lot bigger and we've cropped it down using our special tricks. I want you to make the heading uppercase. I would like you to put a dash border. We used a dotted one earlier on. Create a round all. Round all is the kind of name of this, like this little round thing with some ticks in it. Okay, so I want you to create this with a perfect circle. I want you to group these two together. I want you to rotate them round. Then I'd like you to save and name your file, maybe using the V1. And I'd like you to create a PDF with crop marks. Okay, and then send me a version of it. I'd love to see it. Now, if you get stuck with anything, please drop me a comment or go back through the previous videos. The previous videos will cover everything we've done in here. If you do get lost though, and you're not too sure, drop me a message and I'll give you a hand. Now, I promise you, I've been teaching InDesign for about 12 years now, and it's the people that actually take the effort and do these like little extra examples are the ones that pick it up the most. Following me step by step is awesome until you run into problems. So go ahead, do this one, send me a screenshot, send me a sample. Even if you don't, just keep it on your side, keep it for your portfolio, but make sure you do it. All right, let's go on to the next project. Exciting. So what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off, stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.